Hello, do you know that Medical Council of India has recommended education by means of case studies is the best way of learning a subject? So let me tell you how to learn a subject by referring to a case study. Just see this patient's report and prepare your own questions and find answers. Question 1 is, why non-protein nitrogenous substances like urea and creatinine have increased in blood and in serum? Answer is, patient is suffering from high fever of unknown origin for quite some time and it is a pre-renal condition, and urea nitrogen increases in pre-renal, renal and post-renal conditions. Next question is, what is the pre-renal condition? And answer is, pre-renal conditions are like high fever, dehydration, diabetes mellitus, etc., etc., in which urea rises, and when kidney functions are very much normal and there is no obstruction to the flow and excretion of urine. Next question is, why in prolonged high fever, pyrexia, urea nitrogen increases in blood? And the answer is, during high fever, there is an increase in catabolic reactions, and in these reactions there is a continuous breakdown of tissues, that means proteins, and metabolism of amino acid increases, and end product of amino acid metabolism is urea, and that's why urea rises in blood. Next question is, what is creatinine and why it increases in pre-renal conditions? Creatinine is end product of creatine metabolism, and creatine is required for muscular activities. In this case, patient is also suffering from dehydration and oliguria, that means decreased output of urinary excretion, in which there is a decreased glomerular filtration rate and hence creatinine also slightly increased. Next question is, why bicarbonate fraction has decreased? And the answer is, because of decreased glomerular filtration rate, proper absorption of bicarbonate has not taken place, and that's why this fraction decreases. Next question is, why serum potassium has increased? And the answer is, because of decreased glomerular filtration rate, there is a state of metabolic acidosis in which blood pH has increased, and due to metabolic acidosis, potassium moves from intracellular compartment to extracellular compartment, that is plasma, and that's why in serum and plasma potassium has increased. Well, so like this, you can prepare your own questions by referring to a patient's report, and by means of case study, you can really learn very well. So, all the best and do well.